Bahumana Petta Kerala Governor Sri Justice P. Sadasivam, Tourism Sahakaranam Devaswam Mantri Kerala Tunai Sri Kodakampalli Surendran, Niyama Sabhangam Sri Roji M. John, Deputy Chairman Kochi Turumuka Trust Sri Vengatramana Akarazu, Business Head Asia News Sri Frank P. Thomas, Sringeri Matta Nirvahakan Sri V. R. Gauri Shankar, Adi Shankara Trust Nirvahaki Trust Sri K. Anand, Adi Shankara Institute of Engineering and Technology Kaladi Pradhana Adhyapakan Dr. Neera Kandan. Namaskaram. Ningale Alvarakum Ende Hurdayam Nirangam Swagatam. Chala Asad Haranaraya Kalivulla Yojane Sakaruti Nednal Aghoshikuna Tinai Young Scientist Award Functional and Ivite Santoshamunte. E. Macharatin Yala Vijay Kalayam Ajil Pankatukunavarayam in Abhinandukun. Friends, I can't speak to you in our beautiful, great ancient language Malayalam. I'm sorry for the same. I am happy to be here with all of you today at a special event that celebrates the achievement of our exceptionally talented youngsters. I'm happy to learn Shankara ACNet News Young Scientist Award, a six-level mentored evaluation-based competition launched in 2016. I congratulate the winners of the competition and also those who competed in it. I'm particularly happy among these winners, two are from government-run schools. That speaks of the proper functioning of the government schools and the ability and knowledge and talent of the ordinary children from ordinary families. That is a speciality. And I am also happy that one of the winners is a girl, because we need to encourage our children, particularly girl children. It is indeed very heartening that nearly 300 teams consisting of students competition. I congratulate the top three performing teams who have won a 10-day trip to NASA and Silicon Valley in the United States of America. This award is an eloquent testimony to the inquisitiveness, ingenuity and innovative initiative inherent in our young India. That's what gives us hope and optimism that India will be able to regain its rightful place in the country of nations. Once upon a time, India was known as Vishwa Guru. Students from abroad, they used to come and read in our Nalanda, Takshashila, at that time Takshashila universities. Nearly two-thirds of our country population is below 35 years. We have a demographic dividend. So if you can acquire right mix of knowledge, skills, and attitude required for the 21st century world, the dividends to our country's growth and development can be enormous. I have decided to come to this institute today because you seem to respect the best traditions of the past and are at the same time forward-looking and proactive. Indian history is replete with a number of scientists, mathematicians, physicians, chemists, metallurgists, surgeons, astronomers, and a number of innovators who have significantly advanced human knowledge. One recalls a number of such illustrious names like Aryabhatta, Pingala, Brahmagupta, Bhaskara, Varahamihira, Charaka, Susruta. India gave the concept of zero and the binary system to the world. We knew how to make steel alloys and smelt zinc. Our ancient surgeons could conduct many complicated surgeries, including plastic surgery and cataract surgery at that time. My dear sisters and brothers and young children, advancement of human knowledge have occurred in our country because of the spirit of inquiry, the ability to question, the ability to research, and the ability to arrive at the truth. This requires three qualities. One, first is the willingness to learn from each other, every person, institution and learning resource we can access. That is what the ancient Indian sages have advised us. Let noble thoughts come to us from all over the globe. That is the philosophy we believe in. The second is ability to probe, analyze and synthesize. We should sharpen our skills to analyze, think rationally, logically and be able to segregate fact from fiction. At the same time, we should be able to put different parts of information together and synthesize diverse facts into a coherent ideas. Third quality is to search for a completely out-of-box solution that answers the problem at hand. Innovations enable us to keep leapfrog, take giant leaps, rather grow in a linear sequential mode. I am sure this institute This institute provides the congenial atmosphere required for inculcating these qualities in the students, and there is a facilitative faculty that is willing to go to extra mile to shape young minds and hearts in the best possible manner. Your institute is named after one of the most brilliant philosophers in the world has ever known. Adi Shankara was not only a great philosopher, but an extraordinary poet. He expounded the Advaita philosophy, as per which human beings can become divine through knowledge, and ultimate goal is to experience the Sat-Chit-Ananda, the state of bliss consciousness that emanates from truth and higher consciousness. My dear brothers and sisters, that has been constant message of India. Knowledge must lead to become wise. We must have the wisdom to use knowledge we acquire for improving our lives on this planet. Ultimately, it is Ananda we are all seeking. This is what we are talking about when we talk of gross national happiness. Along with gross national income, we must focus on how science and technology can foster greater happiness and better quality of life, as well as harmonious, inclusive societies. We must learn to live together. Share and care is our basic philosophy. We must not only live for ourselves, we must live for people, for others. We must also love the nature, live with the nature, love and live with the nature. Nature, culture, for a better future. That should be our outlook also. I think we should draw inspiration from the best in the Indian tradition. Remove the dead wood that has also been accumulated over many years and revitalize our country. We should not be insular but always be receptive. We should not only be proud of good ideas we have inherited but also willing to listen to wise words from others also. We should shun complacency. We should abhor mediocrity. We should set our sights higher. A new India beckons all of us. The Prime Minister is speaking of New India, where there is no hunger, where there is no exploitation, where there is no discrimination, where there is recognition for the merit, honesty and integrity, discipline, dedication and devotion. This is what we want to see India moving forward. My young friends, a great opportunity is awaiting us. Fortunately, India is on the move. Even the world economy is slowing down, India is on the rise. Even our powerful neighbor China also going little negative. The only India in the entire world which is moving forward is India, Bharat, that is our motherland. We should all feel proud of the same and join together to strengthen it further. Let me conclude with a favorite quotation. I love to recall very often as to what the father of the nation, Gandhiji, has said. I quote, "I do not want my house to be walled in all sides and my windows to be stuffed. I want the culture of all lands to be blown about my house as freely as possible. But, underline, I refuse to be blown off my feet by any." We should feel proud of our culture, our heritage and our motherland. and our parents and elders and teachers. I always tell wherever I go that every student, every youngster must remember five things in life. One, mother, who has given you the beautiful life. Mother includes father also. The second is Janma Bhumi, the place where you are born. You should never forget it. Back home, as and when you grow, you must do something for the betterment of your native place. Third is mother tongue, the language that has come from your mother's womb. The Malayala, the Tamil, the Kannada, the Telugu, the Punjab, the Assami, Bhojpuri, Hindi, whatever it is, all Indian languages which have come from our mother's womb, they should be respected. At home, we should speak to each other in our mother tongue only, Malayala. When you speak to others, when you speak to foreigners, then you speak in foreign language. But at home, we should follow our culture, our heritage, our tradition, and also our language. Because Bhasha and Bhavana go together. Remember that. You will be able to articulate better in your mother tongue rather than other languages. I am not against other languages. Learn as many languages as possible. Learn Hindi, learn English. Learn even French also, or even Russian, I have no problem. But do not neglect the mother tongue, the Malayala. This has to be understood by one and all. To explain you in a better way, I will tell you, our mother tongue is like our original eyes. The other language, English, is like spectacles. If you have eyes, then the spectacles will work better. If you don't have eyesight, you will not have any sight or foresight also. So keep that in mind and try to practice Malayala at home, in other places. Because people ultimately, they know only Malayala. They don't know English. But at the same time, for scientific advancement, for technology, for knowledge and furtherance, you can learn English. There is nothing wrong. We should also. But do not neglect mother tongue. And the fourth one is the motherland, the country where you are belong to. Atak se lekar Katak tak, Kanyakumari se lekar Kashmir tak, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one, one nation, one people, one country. This should be remembered by one and all. We may be Malayalis, our neighbors may be Tamilians, or the Kannadigas, or the Telugus, or the Marathis, or the Punjabis. Our language may be different, but we are all Indians. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Vividata mein ekata, Bharat ka visheshata. That should be remembered, that we are all one. Our forefathers were one. Our civilization is the same. So, raise your head high. Respect your culture and heritage. And respect your mother, mother tongue and motherland. And then finally, respect your teacher. The guru also is important, who has given you this training, this knowledge, this wisdom. IT has come. IT is very useful. We can make IT also, but mighty. Google is there. Net is there. Net is useful. Google is very useful. But I will tell you that Google can never replace Guru. So Guru has to be remembered and respected throughout the life. I fervently hope that this kind of events become part of our education system, wherein each one of our millions of classrooms of our countries, scientific temper is fostered and creativity is carefully nurtured. Therein lies the future of our country. I'm happy that the AsiaNet has sponsored this program. And then these children who are from ordinary strata of the society, even from government schools, they'll be able to visit NASA, acquire more knowledge, exposed to the other countries and their knowledge also, and come back and strengthen their knowledge and pass it on to others. My dear youngsters, work hard. My advice to all of you is always work hard. Aim high, dream high, then you can reach further heights. That should be remembered. And then everyone must be disciplined. Discipline not for the sake of principal, not for the sake of administrator. Discipline for our own future. If you are disciplined, if you are hard working, if you aim high and dream high, you will reach high. See the example of Dr. Abdul Kalam. He comes from an ordinary background. He was supplying newspapers. But what happened subsequently, because of hard work and dedication, aiming high, dreaming high, you could become a great scientist and president of India, darling of the masses of the country. Even to take the case of the Prime Minister, who has come from a family of a tea vendor, and today is Prime Minister of one of the most powerful countries of the world, India. The reason is hard work, dreaming and aiming high. So that should be the attitude in our future. I'm happy to be addressed to you today and also to felicitate these youngsters. My dear brothers and sisters, is Adi Shankaraji. I am here today. I have never been to Kaladi. So when Ramana has told me that there is a program like this, though it's become tight because I have to go to Guruvayur, there is another important program, come back before sunset and then take flight and go to Andhra Pradesh. But still I agreed because I wanted to see this great place of the great person, a rare spiritual genius who has left an indelible imprint on the hearts and minds of thinkers around the world. Kaladi, this is the holy, hallowed land where Adi Shankara was born in the 8th century AD. Kaladi in Malayalam means, to my understanding, the footprint. Adi Shankara left a permanent footprint on the Indian philosophical and cultural soil. He was a rare blend of a gifted poet, spiritual genius, an institutional builder, unifier, and a philosophical path breaker. He was the greatest exponent of Vedanta and the Upanishadic thoughts the world has ever known. His hymns are among the best literary masterpieces in the world. His influence on the later day philosophers and saints like Swami Vivekananda and Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore is immense. He believed in non-dualism, that Jivatma and Paramatma are not different. In other words, God resides in each one of us and has only to be discovered. His message is of inclusion. Inclusion, that is the need of the hour. We should not exclude anybody. We should not discriminate against anybody. We should not deny opportunities to anybody. We should think inclusively. On his way to Viswanatha temple in Kashi, the city of God and spirituality came upon the untouchable, so-called. And his dog, when asked to move aside by Shankaracharya's disciple, the untouchable asked, "Do you wish that I move my soul, the Atman and everlasting, or this body of clay?" That was the question. Seeing the untouchable, Shankaracharya has realized as none other than the Lord Shiva. Adi Shankara prostrated before Ishvara, the God, before that man. He prostrated himself before that man. So now also, unfortunately, after so many years of civilization and independence, even today you hear here and there untouchability, somebody is not allowed to temple, somebody is not allowed to the other place of worship, somebody is discriminated, high caste, low caste, is all nonsense. It has to be put to an end. It's against our culture, our tradition. The Hindu philosophy never allowed this, but this has come in between. So we have to get rid of this and move towards, as Adi Shankara himself has prostrated before that ordinary person and set an example those days. Even Ramanuja subsequently also, Ramanujacharya also, he also preached inclusiveness and spoke against untouchability. So now time has come for all youngsters, there should be a change of mind. And we should all feel that we are all brethren. That's why I said share and care. The Swamiji also reconciled many different strands of philosophic thought and found parallels in Buddhism as well. Adi Shankaracharya's message is a message of hope, truth and love. That is what is needed today. Adi Shankaracharya is basically known for integrating the entire India. We should not quarrel on the basis of language, caste, religion and region. Unfortunately, it's happening in certain places. We should raise about this and think that we are all one nation only, as I told, one country. He building temples at strategic points of India. He went around to Kashi. He went around to Kashmir. He went around even to Kamakhya temple in Assam, the east, everywhere. Adi Shankaraji. So we are all blessed that we are here, and you are more blessed because you are studying in this institution, and we hope you understand the philosophy of Adi Shankaracharya also, and also the imbibe the qualities of an ideal human being. Once again, I would like to compliment the Adi Shankara Institute, Sringeri Math, and the organizers of this institute for the noble service they are doing for the cause of the education, and also would like to compliment the Asianet Channel, the Airport Trust, and other people for joining together for organizing this good felicitation program to the budding youngsters who are the future of our country. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.